After trailing by 15 in the fourth quarter and 8 with 3:30 remaining, the Dallas Mavericks dropped an avalanche on the state of Tennessee, utterly taking over the game against the team they're now tied with for the third seed in the West. We're going to look at how Dallas did just that in Game 4 of the NBA Cup group stage, and in turn set up a matchup with the first-seeded Oklahoma City Thunder in the quarterfinals of the knockout round to win their fifth straight in his second game back from missing time with a wrist injury. Sixth-year man from Slovenia, Luka Doncic, had 37 points, 12 rebounds, 4 assists, 4 steals, and a block on 11-for-22 shooting from the field and 5-for-9 shooting from distance. Six players in Doncic, Washington, Lively, Dinwiddie, Gafford, and Irving scored in double figures as PJ and Spencer stood on business by draining daggers down the stretch. Before getting to the Mavs' fourth quarter avalanche, over the last 10 games where they've won 9 of them and carved out a place as the third seed in the West and the NBA Cup's Western Conference wildcard team, Dallas is putting the NBA on notice. Over this span, with Luka only having played 4 of those games, the Mavs own the association's second best net rating, the fourth best offensive rating, and the seventh best defensive rating. Definitively standing on business, PJ Washington's averaging 16 points, 9 rebounds, and 4 assists on 50% shooting from the field and a bewildering 52% shooting from distance over his last 8 games. And to further quantify his impact, the Mavs are an impressive 13-4 in the games he's played this season. On the year, 2019's 12th overall pick out of Kentucky and PJ is averaging a career-high 8.6 rebounds per game. And it's great to see that after 4.5 years of losing in Charlotte, the 5th-year pro and 26-year-old shown he can contribute to a winning situation. Albeit through just 17 games of action, Washington's 1.4 steals and 1.2 blocks are like his board-getting average, also career highs, and he's evidently been digging in defensively at a rate that speaks volumes. PJ's 108.0 defensive rating is third best among power forwards, only trailing Jabari Smith Jr. and Draymond Green. Ja Morant hitting a triple to put the Grizzlies up 8 with 3:30 left on Tuesday night seemed to put the Mavs in a hole that would ultimately be overwhelming to overcome. With this Luka step back over Marcus Smart, Doncic instantly cut it back to 5. Washington clamping down on Morant on the other end to force a mid-range miss led to Dereck Lively II drawing a loose ball foul and getting a pair of free throws to cut it to 3. PJ funneling Morant into the help of Lively and forcing the kick out to Jaren Jackson Jr., who bricked the 3, was followed by Marcus Smart reaching in and putting Doncic at the line, which would cut it to 1. Dinwiddie reading that Bane's going to reject this screen, and Lively II making a solid contest would force this Desmond miss, and in transition, Spencer would drain this triple off a dime from Kyrie. Dereck Lively proceeded to clamp up Jackson Jr. around the basket. Then on the other end, Dinwiddie would knock down his second consecutive dagger in the clutch. And a couple possessions later, it was Doncic drawing 2 defenders and kicking a PJ for the wide open deep range bomb. And Washington was damn hyped after sealing the deal. That man stood on business. What a beastly flurry that was from the Mavs roleplayers and Luka, as they turned it up defensively while finding a lethal flow on offense exactly when they needed to. This just shows you why the Mavs are that much more dangerous this year, as even on a night where Kyrie Irving and Klay Thompson struggled, they didn't get the best game from Grimes, who'd been on a tear, and also Najee Marshall was out, they still found a way to dig out a W against a top-tier caliber opponent that was a few buckets away from closing it out. Dallas refused to be denied, as that was one hell of a win. Dereck Lively II touched on how the Mavs were able to pull this one out.
It comes down to grit, you know. There's going to be games where, look back to last year, we were down by 30 and we still came back. So it's just making sure that we talk to one another and make sure the fight never's over, no matter how much we're up, how much we're down.
What's it like to be in the middle of a game before the final few minutes when it just feels like everything's going wrong?
You know, that's just going to be the style of game, you know. Everything's not gonna go our way. Things are gonna go up, things are gonna go down. We just gotta be able to stay consistent throughout the whole game. You know, no matter if that's the refs calling, no matter if that's us turning the ball over, us making bad decisions or taking bad shots, we've got to be able to settle into the game. You know, take a deep breath, focus on what we need to do, and play the way we need to play.
Is that what you did when you had the missed free throws and then you stepped up for the final two and made both?
Yep, you know, being in positions like that, you got to make them, you know. Got to be able to put everything outside of your head and lock in, make those two free throws. Shout out my mama.
Luka Doncic had four steals in this game, and while he's had moments of letting the team down on the defensive end that got heavily shed light on by doubters, the Slovenian sensation does rank second in the NBA among all point guards in defensive rating, only trailing Houston's Fred VanVleet in this category. Doncic was asked about his defense post-game.
It said five for a little bit.
Did you think he had five? Defense, whoa. I'm trying. I think this season has been one of the best defensive seasons. I know people don't see it, but I'm trying and I'll just get better.
What area on defense would you say you have grown the most?
Just overall. A little bit of everything, more energy. That's it.
On a night where Kyrie shot just 3 for 14 from the field and 0 for 4 from distance, both Luka and Dereck gave their takes on Irving.
I had to see him kind of struggle the way he did on the offensive end.
Yeah, very well. But just, I know everybody here looks just the shots. He did more things, you know. It's not only about the shots. Sometimes they're going to fall, sometimes no. With Kyrie, a lot of times, yes. But he did a lot of other stuff, so that's it.
I think you guys are still everyone.
He's still Kyrie. You know, he trusts us to pick him up whenever. He trusts us to pick him up no matter what night it is, because he's always going to pick us up. You're always going to lean on him for guidance, for leadership, and some nights you're going to lean on us to give him a pick him up and try to be able to take a little bit of the load off him, because you know he's been doing so much for us. We got to help him out.
This was your boy D Flow, and I'll see you next video.